If you remember, you know, 3 years prior to today's gospel, Jesus came to the apostles and called them away from their life as fishermen. And then in today's gospel, we see Peter and then, of course, the other disciples following him returning to that activity. And the interesting thing is that they don't catch anything. And, you know, they were, I'm sure, very good at making a living that way before. But then when they hit the water again for the first time in a while, for whatever reason, maybe they forgot the good forms or, you know, how to do it properly. But it doesn't work like it used to. And Jesus then offers a strategy change and tells them, hey, try doing it this way. Try the other side of the boat. Try casting it out. And of course they do, and the nets are overflowing and almost tear. And I think that is an important lesson for us today too, not just those of us who like to fish, but for everybody. And there's a spiritual lesson I think that is really important and is the reason it is included in the gospel. Not just when we're fishing, but I think all the time we ought to be people who are asking Christ to look at how we do things and say, any suggestions? Are there things that we can be doing differently? Are there ways to improve the strategies and the techniques that we are using ourselves? Lord, Christ, we turn to you and we say, look at what we're doing, and do you have any suggestions or ways to improve what we are about? And really interestingly then, this week, just yesterday actually, Pope Francis announced an initiative basically where, as the universal church, as the worldwide church, we will be doing that. He appointed a group of 8 cardinals, and they will be meeting over the course of the next year or so to look at the Vatican, the sort of the universal church and how it's structured and governed, and to see, are there things that we could be doing differently at that universal worldwide level of the church? Very similar to what we find in today's gospel. It's basically the apostles, but now, of course, being in our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and some of the other cardinals saying, Lord, here's how we have things structured. Here's how we have things set up. Are there ways that we can adjust that? Are there things that we can cut? Are there things that we can add? Are there things that we can be doing differently? And sometimes in our pride, we don't want to look to Christ. We're very self-sufficient people. And yet, Pope Francis is kind of leading the way and saying, as the worldwide church, we're going to turn to Christ and say, Lord, are there things that we can be doing differently? And I think that also then applies to not just the worldwide church, but also our local church. Every local parish throughout the world ought to be doing that, you know, it should just be a regular part of parish life. How are we meeting the needs of our local community, of ourselves, and also of those who live in our larger, our city or our parish boundaries, whatever we want to say? How are we doing? Are there ways that are suggestions that Christ has for us in terms of how to do things better? And then, of course, I think the third level of that is not just the worldwide church, not just our parish, but also myself. We turn to the Lord, hopefully, and we're saying from time to time, Lord, will you come in and evaluate how I'm living my life, how I'm practicing my faith? And will you offer suggestions, ways to improve? I was thinking as I was reading this gospel and praying over it, I was reminded, you know, and kind of convicted in a way, in the sense that I was looking at my prayer life and the sort of the things, and it's been good. I try to make a holy hour every day and try to pray a rosary every day and have been very faithful to that. But I was also having to say, you know, that's basically been what I've done since the seminary. And maybe I need to turn to Christ and say, you know, Lord, any suggestions? Here's my spiritual life. Here's how I've been practicing it. Here's been the techniques and the things that I've been doing in my life. Do you have suggestions? Are there things that I should be doing differently? Are there things I can add to my spiritual life? And so I think that, again, today's gospel is not just a lesson for fishermen. It's a lesson for all of us. You know, we strike that balance between finding rest and comfort and consistency in our faith. You know, there's a great joy that what we do here and what we live in our faith is the same, and we rest in that. We know, again, that what we celebrate here in the Mass goes back to the very beginning of the church, and there's comfort in that, and that's a gift of God, from God. And yet we're also living in tension with that call to also be examining and looking for new ways and new things that we can be doing as an individual, as a parish, and as a worldwide church. And so as we do that, hopefully in our lives and throughout our Catholic faith, as we do that, hopefully we turn and have the humility to turn to Christ and say, Lord, any suggestions, ways to improve, ways to grow closer to you? Trusting and knowing, as the apostles learned in today's gospel, that when we turn to Christ and we offer and seek his advice, the nets and the catch that we make is oftentimes overflowing.